In a news conference today at the Ministry of Finance headquarters in Kampala, the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Finance, Ramadan Gobi, said in the first quarter they have released 4.676 trillion shillings, excluding debts. The biggest portion of these funds has been allocated to wages, pension and gratuity.
The wage, that is 1,603.6 billion shillings, and pension and gratuity of 230 billion have been fully provided for this quarter.
The budget for the arrears has been fully released and allocated 662 billion shillings. Security agencies, Defense, External Security Organization and the Internal Security Organization have been provided 721 billion. 47.6 billion has been provided for judiciary. 175 billion has been provided to Parliament. Health institutions have received 160 billion shillings. 96 billion has been provided for universities. 13 billion shillings has been provided for agriculture, while Ministry of Defense, State House and Ministry of Works have been allocated 26 billion shillings.
The quarter one release of Government of Uganda funds, excluding debt, amounts to 4.676 trillion shillings. That's what we've released for quarter one. 4,676 billion shillings. That is net of debt. 175 billion has been provided to Parliament. The recurrent release for health institutions, that is 160 billion, has been fully prioritized and released. 96 billion has been provided for recurrent expenditure for local governments. 98 billion has been provided for universities.
Stringent regulations have, however, been issued to all government accounting officers. They must ensure that they pay wages, salaries, pension and gratuity by the 28th of every month. They must display payrolls for salaries and monthly pension on notice boards every month. They should prioritize paying of service providers on time. No recruitment should be done without clearance from the Ministry of Public Service, among others.
Accounting officers are requested, and I emphasize, to ensure that they pay wages, salaries, pensions, and gratuity by the 28th of every month. Number three, there should be a display of the payrolls for salaries and monthly pension on government institutions' notice boards every month to ensure transparency. Accounting officers must prioritize payment of service providers on time and clearance of domestic arrears to avoid further accumulation of arrears and penalties.
This time round, government will not entertain any supplementary expenditures apart from those for security or industrial policy purposes. The good news, however, is that despite all the challenges, the prospects for the economy for this year are positive and the economy is expected to grow at 6.5%. Civil society activists have, however, advised government to come up with quick measures to arrest the challenge of drought that has seen people in Karamoja die due to hunger. They too have advised that before the disbursement of the parish development model funds, government should ensure that every parish has a fully appointed chief to oversee the funds so that they are not misused. Story by Jaliat Namoya for the news.